Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can trigger a Lambda function whenever something is uploaded to an S3 bucket. So we're going to assume that you're going to be uploading some type of file where you want to then do some processing on that file, you want to read the data, and then possibly perform some external actions. And so as an example, I have this very basic JSON object that just says hello world inside of it, and if I go to my S3 bucket, I can then upload that file. I can click on add files. I can select to process.json and I can click on upload. And this is automatically going to trigger this Lambda function here. And so if I go into CloudWatch and I click on refresh, we then see this CloudWatch log right here. Clicking on it, we then see our file right here, which is hello world. And so this can be used for text files, JSON files, any type of text-based file that you want. You can then go through and then run whatever type of processing you want on the file contents. And so that's what we're going to be creating in this video, and we're going to get started right now. So the first thing we need to do is we need to actually create an S3 bucket. I'm going to name mine warrantoffkeys files to process, and we can keep all the defaults the same, so we can just click on create right here. After that, we can navigate into our S3 bucket, and we see that there's nothing here. We could then go to Lambda, open this in a new tab, and I want to create a new Lambda function. This one will be called process-files. And I'm going to select a very basic role that is essentially going to just let me use CloudWatch logs. I can then click on the create function. Now we need to actually create this function. And so I'm going to go into VS Code. I've initialized a basic node project here, and I have this empty index file. And then we also have our file that we want to actually process in our Lambda function. So to start things off, I'm going to import the AWS SDK. This is installed globally on my machine, and you can do that by running npm install-g aws-sdk. However, if you don't want to install it globally, you can remove the -g. So now I'm going to create an S3 object. This will be equal to new aws.s3. And then I'm going to create a main function, which will be an asynchronous function that takes in one parameter, which is the event. And then to make sure that Lambda has access to this, I can use exports.handler equals main. Now inside of here, I'm going to simply console log the event just so I can understand what's happening. And I'm going to return an empty string. Now I can copy this code and we're going to paste it inside of our Lambda function. So I can go over here and I can paste this into here. I can control S to save in the inline editor and I can click on save the top right. Now to make sure this function is working correctly, I'm gonna first minimize my console here. I'm gonna configure a new test event. I'm gonna call this test and I'll keep the default object here. I can click on create and then I can click on test. Now here, if I expand this, it's going to return an empty string as our code says. However, we see our console log right here for our events, and so everything seems to be working fine. Next, I'm going to go to the designer section and I'm going to click on add trigger. I'm going to search for S3 and then I'm going to select our specific bucket. So warrantoffkeys files to process. I'm going to keep the event type as all object created. And then if you wanted a specific prefix, for example, if you were uploading this into like an images folder or into a files folder or something like that, you can specify that. However, if we leave this blank, it'll just listen for every object uploaded to our S3 bucket. After that, we can listen for specific files. For example, we have a .json file here. So if we wanted to, we can specifically listen for .json. However, if we leave this blank, it'll also listen for everything. And here we want to enable the trigger. Now this section here is important depending on your use case. In this video, it won't be relevant. However, this is essentially just making sure that you are aware that if you are uploading files to S3 as a result of triggering a Lambda function, that you cannot upload them to the same exact S3 bucket. This is essentially just going to make it so the Lambda function triggers again, and then it's going to upload to the same bucket, and it's going to recursively keep doing that, which is going to increase your costs because you are infinitely running a Lambda function. So if you are going to then process some type of file that you got from S3 and you want to upload that to S3 again, you should use a different bucket. And this is just making sure that you acknowledge that. So then we can click on add. Okay, so now I'm going to go to my monitoring and I'm going to view the logs in CloudWatch, which opens this in a new tab. And if we go in here, we see the test event we had. I can actually go back and I'm going to delete this. Now to make sure that the trigger works, I'm going to upload my file. So I can click on upload, add files, and I can click on my toProcess.json file, and I can click on upload. So now we can go to our CloudWatch logs, we can click on refresh, and we see this log stream right here. Clicking on this, we see some information. And inside, we see that we have a records array with an S3 object. This is important. If we go back to our code, we can say const object equals event.records index 0.s3. Now we want to gain access to the actual bucket. So we can say constant bucket equals s3.bucket.name. And then we can say constant file equals s3.object.key. And this will give us the necessary information to actually read the file. And so to do that, we actually need to give this Lambda function access to that. So we can go into IAM and open this in a new tab. So I'm going to go to roles, and then I'm going to click on create role. I'm going to select Lambda because that's what we're actually using for this functionality here. I can click on next permissions. I'm going to search for an existing policy I have that essentially just lets me read CloudWatch logs. This will basically just give me access to everything when it comes to CloudWatch. So I'm going to select that. But then we also want to create a policy. So the service for this will be S3. We're going to attach a policy to our Lambda function that allows us to read all files in that specific S3 bucket. So I can click on read. We can scroll down to get object, which is the function we'll be using, and you'll see that in Node.js here in a minute. Now under resources, we want to specifically specify the exact bucket. So our bucket name is one-off keys files to process. I can copy that. I can paste it in the bucket name, and then object name can be any. We can click on add and then review policy. I'm going to name this S3 process files, and then I can create the policy. So it says our policy has been created. Going back over to our roles, we can click on refresh right here. And then I can start searching for the policy, which was named S3 process files. So I can say S3 process files, and we see it right here. We can select it and then go to next. We're going to leave the tags blank. We can click on review. And I typically like to name our roles the same exact name as the Lambda function that we'll be using them. So I can say process-files, and I can click on create role. The role has been created. Going over to Lambda, we can go back to our configuration tab. We can scroll down. Oops, we have to click on process files right here. So we were in the trigger options. We want to click on the main options right here in the middle. Scrolling down, we should see basic settings. We can click on edit and then existing role. So I want to do a search for process files, and we see it right here. If you don't see it, you might have to click on the refresh icon. We could then click on save. And so now this function, once we click on save again, this function will have access to actually reading certain S3 files. So going back into here, we are now going to want to return a promise. So we can actually get rid of this empty string here. So we can return await new promise. We're going to pass in our resolve and our reject. Now, because we're using await, it's important that this function is asynchronous, which I already have right here. Now I'm going to create a parameters object. So the first thing will be our bucket with a capital B, and this will be our local object right here. And then we're going to have our key, which is going to be our file. I'm just noticing an error I have up here. We want to use this object instead of S3. So the bucket should be object.bucket.name, and the file should be object.object.key. And so now we have these parameters here. We can now say s3.getObject. We can pass in our parameters, and we're going to get a callback, which is going to give us an error or our result. Now inside of here, I can say if there's an error, we're simply going to reject with the error. Otherwise, we are going to console log the result. And then I also want to resolve with an empty object here. So here we're going to gain access to the actual file. And if we were to console log this, then you would see that it is going to be inside of a buffer. And so we want to actually run toString on that. So we can say const contents equals result.body with a capital B dot toString. And then here we can console log the contents. And if we save this, we could then copy this entire file and go back into our Lambda editor and paste it right here. We can then control S to save in the inline editor and then click on save at the top right. Now we can go back to our logs, and I want to delete all of the current log streams for this. And I'm going to go back to my S3 bucket, and I'm going to re-upload the same file. So now that that has been re-uploaded, we can go back to the logs. We can click on refresh. We see the log stream right here. We see no events found. We might have to wait a few seconds. After a few seconds of refreshing, we then see this, and we see our contents right here, which is hello world, which is the exact contents of our actual file that we uploaded. And so this is how you're going to automatically detect file uploads to an S3 bucket using Lambda and Lambda triggers. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.